wave your hands and shout hallelujah. If you love the Lord, wave that hands and shout louder, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Give your neighbor high five. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, I am convinced right now that my blessing will be bigger than yours. If there is any man God will bless, me number one,
me number one,
you number 49,
you number 49.
Give the Lord a shout and a clap. Take your seat. I want to salute the general, the father of this house, in the person of Prophet Didi Isaac and his most anointed wife, the mama in the house, Mama Hope. I want you to celebrate them with a clap offering. God can give to you after Jesus is a gift of a pastor.
Amen.
Please take the keyboard down. It's a gift of a pastor. I want you people to cherish them, love them, protect them, keep them. Don't allow anyone attack them. They are the prophet that points you to your destiny.
Amen.
They are life for you. Don't play with them. Always protect them. Don't fight them.
Amen.
Stand by them. And as you support them, the Lord will continue to bless you.
I receive.
And he will continue to prosper you.
I receive.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
I receive it.
Thank you for inviting me. God bless you. Like I said, I am your assistant pastor. So this is my church in Johannesburg. I preached somewhere this morning. I said I was a guest speaker. They are here. I am assistant pastor. Amen. How many of you have been blessed since the conference began? Tonight, this hour, we are climaxing.
Amen.
Even the color of your skin will change. Weighty glory is about to fall upon you.
Receive it.
Lift up your hands. That's who you are. 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 Adonai. 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 Elohim. That's who you are. That's who you are. That's who you are. That's who you are. Father, move like a volcano this afternoon. Invade this house like you invaded the baritone of Joseph the Arimathea. Touch life, transform destiny. Let the words that will come out of my mouth for a few minutes transform them and take them to their next level. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. And let God's people shout out amen like a thunder.
Amen.
Romans, thank you, chapter 8 and verse number 19. For the earnest expectations of the creature, they waited eagerly for the manifestations of the sons of God. Preaching a few minutes on what I title provoking the supernatural. Lift up your hand, say, I provoke the supernatural. Lift up your hand, say, I wire my destiny to the supernatural. Say, I connect my entire existence to the supernatural. For the earnest expectations of the creature, they waited eagerly for the manifestation of the sons of God. Our generation is in travail. Our world is in great pain. Our parents are praying, asking God to change the life of their children so that they can come and clean their tears. The whole world is in turmoil. They are waiting for their release. And the Bible says it is the sons that are hooked up to the supernatural that are going to liberate this generation from satanic insurgence and incursion. And I believe you are one of those sons that is about to be revealed in your generation. The best of your life is about to be unraveled. The greatness of your destiny is about to be seen. If they think they know you, they should wait for you 7 days from now. The gloriousness of your destiny is about to be made manifest. From today, I declare, let the supernatural take over your life. Where the natural fail you, I command you cross to the supernatural. I say cross to the supernatural. In the mighty name of Jesus. What is supernatural manifestation? Number one, they are the inexplicable occurrences from the actions and thoughts and reactions of the supernatural man. They are the inexplicable occurrences. They are the happenings that cannot be explained in the thoughts and actions and reactions of the man that operates the supernatural. Any man operating the supernatural, the happenings around him cannot be ordinary. The happening around him cannot be natural. It will have some touch of divine elements. From today, I declare, your daily existence will be existence of supernatural manifestations. Number two, what is supernatural manifestation? They are the expression of our inherent divinity in all ramification of our activities and personality. They are the inherent expression of our divinity. The inherent expression of our divinity in all ramification of our existence, of our activities, and of our personality. I came to let you know that we serve a God that is extraordinary in nature. We serve a God that is not a normal God. And we are a believer of a book that is extraordinary in nature. We are a believer of a book that defied the law of biology. When a woman became pregnant without the spermatozoa of a man, we are a believer of a book that defied the law of chemistry. When water turned to wine, we are a believer of a book that defied the law of physics. When Jesus walked upon water, we are a believer of a book that defied the law of economics. When 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes fed 5,000 people and 12 baskets remained. We are a believer of a book that defied the law of anatomy. When a man died for 4 days and after 4 days he bounced back to life. We are a believer of a book that defied the law of gravity by reason of many raptures and ascensions that took place in scriptures. Sir, ma, you cannot be carrying this book and produce result like a cursed man. You cannot be carrying this book and produce result like a man that is under a spell. From today, I command your result to be extraordinary. I command your testimonies to be extraordinary. Can I talk to somebody here? After today, all your life shall be extraordinary. Man of God, the monkey's display of a monkey is not a miracle. It is his nature. He has a monkeyous anointing. So he can chimpanzee and monkey from tree to tree. Not by fasting and prayer. It is his nature. The massive poo-poo of an elephant is not a prayer point. It is his nature. The massive poo-poo of an elephant, he doesn't need to fast. He can download a poo-poo that is as massive as a live chicken. Because his nature is colossal. His nature is massive. So he cannot download binchomic, microscopic, and myopic poo-poo. But gargantuan poo-poo. Why? Because of his nature. How can you be a child of God and you are producing results like a man that is under a curse? Somebody say, I refuse. From today I declare, where others fail, that is where you will succeed. Where it is not working for others, it will begin to work for you. Lift up your hands, say, my life connects to the supernatural. Seat. Number three, what is supernatural manifestation? Supernatural manifestation is occasionally celestial participation in mortal difficulties. Someone say occasionally celestial participation in mortal difficulties. That means in every occasion, they are unraveling their celestial capacity. Because we belong to two realms. The realm of the terrestrial and the realm of the celestial. The realm of mortality and the realm of immortality. So when the terrestrial fails you, you cross to the realm of the celestial. From that realm, you will call those things that be not as though they were. From that realm, you will fire people out of your life. From that realm, you will deal with every enemy of your destiny. Lift up your hands from today. I command my celestial atmosphere to open. Somebody says celestialism. Say celestialism. It is from that realm where you are invisible to your enemies. How can they invoke you in their mirror and you appear like a lamb ready to be slaughtered? You can't find me in their mirror. Touch me by mistake, die by correction. Too defended and protected to be arrested. Too blessed to be cursed. Too loaded, so I must be needed. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody here. I carry something that forbids any mortal man to humiliate me. I carry something that will cause my forehead to destroy every enemy of my glory. You don't fear native doctor. You are prayed from that realm. You are prayed from that realm. Armed robbers came to my heart, to my church in the office. 11 of them, they came with guns. They put one on my head, one here, one here, one here. They say, lie down. I stood up, put my hand in my pocket. I say, a man of God does not lie down. He says, shoot him. I say, you can't shoot me. He that is born of God, the Lord God keepeth him, and the wicked one cannot touch him. The armed robber said, are you calling me a wicked man? I said, Bible say you are wicked. Not me. Bible say you are wicked. Take your seat. For 1 hour, they couldn't get me to lie down. So they say, okay, pastor, sit down. I say, it's better. I'm seated together with Christ. Sitting position is allowed in scripture. But how can I lie down? Illiterate, we use their boots on my head. Anointed head. Mba, it's not possible. Somebody say, it is not possible. Say, I am operating from another realm. He that is from above is above all. From today, take your place. Take your place. Take your place. Take your place. Somebody shall fire. Fire. terrestrial fail you, switch to the celestial. Anytime things begin to work against you, just withdraw and connect the heavenly antenna. Then cross horizontal line of confidence to the realm of all reality. Begin to speak in tongues in capital letters. That is the language of the spirit. Somebody shout fire, fire.
Fire, fire. General.
Am I talking to somebody here?
Oh, yes.
From today, I prophesy. Whatever make you look ordinary,
I receive.
It is over.
I receive.
Become extraordinary.
I receive.
Too loaded to be harassed.
I receive.
I command your fear to fall upon your bosses.
I receive.
Fall upon every unbeliever.
I receive.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
I receive.
Shout, I am not ordinary.
I am not ordinary.
Take your seat. What is supernatural manifestation number four? They are the accompanying signs of your origin. The accompanying signs of your origin. They show your wonderful activities of your spiritual personality. They show your origin. They show that you are not from this realm. You are from another realm. Though you are in this world, but you are not of this world.
Yes.
Your nature is a divine nature.
Amen.
You are not subject to the corruption of this life. That is why if they give you poison, it will become vitamin C. That is why for 30 years, I cannot be sick. I can never lay my back on the hospital bed.
Amen.
Even if all the witches leave your village and attack me, they cannot make me sick. Because I know my origin.
Oh, yes.
My source. I am not from this realm. Am I talking to somebody here?
Yes.
So after today, stop walking like a vulture that rain has beaten. After today, walk like you own the earth.
Amen.
Because the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof.
Ah.
Square your shoulder. Walk braggadociously.
Amen.
Walk tenaciously.
Yes.
The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof.
Yes.
And anybody that does not like you can as well go and kiss the transformer.
Yes.
Am I talking to somebody here?
Yes,
because you must succeed by all means. Somebody shout by force, by fire.
By force, by fire.
I must succeed. Take your seat.
Power.
Take your seat. What is supernatural manifestation? Number five, it is precipitating divine involvement in natural matters. Somebody say precipitating divine involvement in natural matters. Engaging divinity in humanity affairs. Calling the celestial into the terrestrial. Calling the super on the natural. Calling the extra on the ordinary. Not looking at things normally. Looking things with the eye of the spirit. When Satan's voice is speaking through your friend, you should know. Get deep behind me, Satan. Am I talking to somebody here?
Oh, yes.
Am I talking to somebody here?
Oh, yes.
So you must know that you are not ordinary. Carry yourself with a sense of divinity. So, involve the supernatural in your daily dealings. We want to do a deal. Can I pray? Do I go into this deal? That is how. You want to marry, pray. You are going to carry any kind of person as husband, as wife. No wonder you thought you have wife, now you have knife. Because you didn't pray. You thought you have husband, now he's hunchback. You didn't pray. Because when you pray and engage spiritual things into your affairs, you make minimal mistake and you maximize impact. And your result becomes very colossal. And men cannot ignore it. From today I prophesy.
I receive.
Let the supernatural
I receive.
Take over the affairs of
I
your life.
I receive it.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
I receive it.
Number five. What is supernatural manifestation? Number six, am I right? Number six, what is supernatural manifestation? They are the incomprehensible manifestations from the accomplishment, belief, and the antiphon of the paranormal. now they are the incomprehensible manifestations from the belief, the accomplishment, and the antiphon of the paranormal. In short, you are not normal. That's all I'm telling you. A man in the supernatural is not a normal man. His walking step is not normal. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody here. Attack them, you are wasting your time. Because the fire will answer for them. I don't know if I'm talking to people here.
Oh, yes.
So they are the incomprehensible manifestation from the accomplishment, belief, the antiphon of the paranormal. They are not normal. They are not normal. Even the way they talk, they are not normal. They command results that are fearful. They command results that are mind-blowing. They command testimonies that you can't trace their source. When you look at their input and look at their output, it's irreconcilable. There is a hand behind the scene working for them. There's a hand behind the scene compelling breakthroughs in their favor. After today, you'll be modificated.
I receive it.
What is supernatural manifestation number 7? They are the complementary cryptograms of your foundation. Somebody say complementary cryptograms of your foundations. They show your credos and the undertaking of your uncanny disposition. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying here? They are what? Complementary cryptograms of your foundation. They show your credo and the undertaking of your uncanny disposition. In short, I mean, supernatural manifestation means astonishing performance. It means uncanny research. Am I talking to somebody here?
Oh, yes.
I'm talking about transcendent enactments. Is somebody... Can I define it?
Yes.
Because there is no English. Supernatural manifestation means ekuta baraka to biba
fatosha.
Frekete ekumaragodos. That is supernatural manifestation. Men who operate from that realm, they are not normal. They are not normal. They hold Ebola. Ebola dies. You bring HIV, touch their blood, HIV dies. They are not normal. From the day I started preaching, no wristwatch survives in my hand. Every wristwatch, when I preach 5 minutes, it condemns. Because the power in my spirit electrocutes wristwatches.
Ah! Power!
No wristwatch survives when I preach. It electrocutes wristwatches. I have more than 100 wristwatches. None of them is working. Including this one.
General.
Because hear me, when the supernatural is operating, natural seasons are suspended. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody here. Natural seasons. Your results are not natural. It took people 30 years to get certain things. You get it within 3 months. That is supernatural happenings. Open your hands. I prophesy.
I receive
from today throughout this year.
I receive
the things that will be happening around you.
I receive.
We make people to open their mouths.
I receive.
They cannot explain.
I receive.
They left you here.
I receive.
But they will see you there.
I receive.
They left you as a single.
I receive.
But they will meet you with your husband.
I receive.
They met you without a child.
I receive.
But they will see your 2 children.
I receive.
They thought you will die poor.
I receive.
But you will invite them for your house dedication. You invite them for your car dedication. The devil is a liar. If God be for us, who can be against us? If God is on your side, power is on your side. Anointing is on your side. Favor is on your side. Breakthrough is on your side. We don't serve a dead God. We serve a living God. He's the same yesterday. He's the same today. He's the same forever. When God says yes, no man can say no. When God lifts you up, no man can bring you down. Lift your hand, shout fire. Somebody say, Lord, connect me to the supernatural. Shout it louder.
Lord.
Uh-huh. Connect me to the supernatural. Again, Lord.
Lord.
Wire my life.
Wire my life
to the supernatural.
To the supernatural.
When the supernatural is at work, you get job without interview.
I receive.
When the supernatural is at work,
I receive.
There is arrival without journey.
I receive.
When the supernatural is at work,
I receive.
There is money without effort.
I receive.
When the supernatural is at work,
I receive.
There is marriage without dating.
I receive.
When the supernatural is at work,
I receive.
There is ministry without sweat.
I receive.
There is attainment without steps.
I receive.
There is manifestation without effort.
I receive.
From today, I wire your life.
I
wire your business. I wire your career.
I
wire your children to the supernatural. Remain a mystery.
I receive it. Power. General.
Take your seat. What does the supernatural produce in you? It produces seven things. But I'll mention only two and then pray for you. And you can continue. So that I go and rest. Hear this. Number one, when the supernatural is at work, you become an enigma. Someone say enigma.
Enigma.
You become an unsolvable puzzle. What did I say? Unsolvable puzzle. You become a puzzle to your generation. You become a matter clothed, hidden. You become mysterious. Because, sir, it takes mystery to handle mystery.
Uh-huh.
Wickedness is a mystery.
Uh-huh.
But righteousness is also a mystery.
Uh-huh.
Unto you it is given to know the mysteries of the kingdom.
Uh-huh.
Any man in the supernatural realm is a man in possession of mystery.
Uh-huh.
And by mystery, you can demystify the mysteries of wickedness.
Uh-huh.
By mystery, you can demystify the mystery of satanic aggression.
Uh-huh.
The unfavorable conditions of life, adversaries and adversities can be swallowed because it takes mystery to answer mystery. Wickedness is a mystery. Two couples love themselves, married. 2 years after, divorce is the only solution. What has happened? Life is a mystery. A woman is pregnant 9 months and deliver a child that is deformed. Who is to be blamed? Life is a mystery. A man labors from morning to night and comes back home empty. Who is to be blamed? Life is a mystery. A man caught you for 6 years, promising to take her to see your parents. When it is time to see your parents, he carries your friend and take her to the altar. Who is to be blamed? Life is a mystery. The day you make up your mind to solve the mysteries of life with your effort, you will end up moribundic, mundanic, and end up frustrated. You will end up in catastrophe and cataclysm. Am I talking to somebody here?
Oh, yes.
But the day you hook up to the supernatural, you also become mysterious. Am I talking to somebody here?
Oh, yes.
From that realm, mystery jam mystery. Where power jam power. This lesser power shall bow. Am I talking to somebody here?
Oh, yes.
Shoe has his size. Shoe has his size.
Oh, yes.
You wear oversized, you suffer. You wear undersized, you suffer. Tell your neighbor,
neighbor,
I am a mystery.
I am a mystery.
After today, if I see you in my dream,
if I see you in my
Holy Ghost
dream,
fire.
Holy Ghost fire.
Power. General. Take your seat. Someone say, life is a mystery.
Life is a mystery.
Say it again.
Life is a mystery.
Stand up. I'm seeing something about you. My spirit left my body. I'm seeing myself walking in Bamenda. In Cameroon.
Accurate prophecy.
In Cameroon.
Accurate prophecy.
I see an angel uprooting an altar.
I receive.
It's a less celestine.
I receive. That's my name.
Be released. Wow. This man is pulling something from me in the realm of the spirit.
I receive.
Hear me.
I receive.
If you don't become rich,
I receive.
I will throw my Bible.
I receive.
Stand up. Let me put something on you. Remove your suit. Let me put something on you. Ah! General! Power! Yes! Zekoteka. If the wife is there, join now because the two shall be one. I release the mysteries that turn ordinary men to supernatural men. Say, Lord,
Lord,
connect me to the supernatural.
To the supernatural.
Take your seat. When the supernatural is on you, you are mysterious. You see with spiritual eyes. You cross horizontal line of confidence. From that realm, you temper with people. You temper with situation. You temper with powers. You frustrate forces. You end aggression, and then you manifest glory. Somebody will enter that realm now. Not tomorrow, now. Number two, what does the supernatural produce in you? It produces in you a change of smell. Someone say, change of smell. Ma, sir, hear me well in case your heart has traveled home to this Sunday rise. Let it come back now because I want to talk to you. Life is about your smell. How you smell determines what you attract. Your smell determines the kind of husband you will marry. Your smell determines the kind of wife you will marry. Your smell determines the area of town you will live in. If you are living in a poor area, you are carrying a smell of poverty. Life is about smell. The anointing empowers you, but your smell announces you. Your smell determines the kind of money that will enter your hand. Your smell determines the kind of clothes you will buy. Your smell determines the kind of car you will live in. Your smell determines the kind of woman you will marry and the kind of husband you will marry. If you are marrying a pinchomic, yeyeshus, mumushus husband, it's because you carry a smell of yeyeshus life. Sister, how come correct people will never ask you for marriage? Only people that can't feed well. Hello, my name is Piccolo Piccolo. That is bad luck. My friend, that is bad luck. Where are the lawyers? Where are the engineers? Where are the doctors? Why is your star not attracting them? Smell. Can I have water? Pastor, your smell determines the kind of members you will have. Your smell determines the kind of members you have. And your smell determines the kind of area your church will exist. Life is about smell. I have a friend of mine. Everywhere we go to preach, they give me money, millions. But him, they will give him prophetic handshake. If they manage to give him offering, his pinchomic offering, they will give me cars. They will never give him. At the time, I was giving over 78 cars. He has not been given one. I go with him to preach. I will preach Thursday, Friday. They will bless me. He will preach Saturday, Sunday. They will shake him and say, thank you for coming. The blessing you gave us, may God give you back. That is all shake. One day he came to me, he said, man of God, at least you are not preaching better than me. I said, yes, you are a territorial commander. He said, why is it that everywhere we go, they bless you, they don't bless me? I looked at him and said, deal with your smell. He said he was so ashamed to ask me what smell means. So he decided to fast for 7 days. On the seventh day, he was praying on his altar. When the Lord opened his eyes, he saw an old woman on top of his altar urinating on him. When the woman finished urinating on him, bunch of flies followed him. As he's talking to his members, they will be listening. When he turned, bunch of flies invade the members. They turn their face. The Lord said, that is how you are. That's why nobody helps you. There are people here. Nobody has given you gift in life. Nobody has ever blessed you. The reason is because of your smell. Sir, If everything you have in this life is what you sweated for, you are a miserable man. There is a place of favor where you drive cars you don't buy. You own houses you did not build. You travel abroad on the ticket of favor.
Oh, yes.
I've been given over 150 cars without buying one. Every month, three, four, every month. Anywhere I enter, they are loving me. Even if they don't give other pastors, anywhere I enter, they will honor me. Because I smell monies. Come on, hit your neighbor, say, I smell monies.
I smell monies.
Tell your neighbor, say, I'm highly monificated.
I'm highly monificated.
Say, I'm highly monicious. Say,
monicious.
I am monidated.
I am monidated.
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 Monified. Monicious.
Monicious.
I smell monies.
I smell monies.
Pow! Cheddar. Hey. Somebody here with me.
Oh, yes.
So, he said, Lord, what do I do with this old woman? He said, command her to die. He prayed and commanded her to die. He said, Lord, what next? He said, ask me to change your smell. So he said, Lord, change my smell. So he called me. I told him, welcome to the club of good smell. He said, what do you mean? I said, I knew the encounter God gave you. Your smell has changed now. Can I pray for you, man of God? So I prayed for him. That the next week, I was preaching in Gwagolada, Abuja. Then I used to be in Jos. Plateau State. So I said to him, man of God, you are going to minister Saturday and Sunday. I'll preach Thursday, Friday, I'll go back to church. You can continue. On Sunday after church, the man of God called me. He said, man of God. I said, how are you, sir? He said, your friend blessed us. The Lord has been impressing in my heart to give him my Mercedes. I want to take your permission. Should I give him? I said, what are you waiting for? Give it to him. For the first time, he got a Mercedes. The following week, I was preaching in the oil company in the oil state of Nigeria, Port Harcourt. And I finished Thursday, Friday, I left. The man of God preached Saturday, Sunday. He preached Sunday night again. In the night, around 11 p.m., my phone rang. The man of God called. He said, man of God, he said, this your friend is good. I said, yeah. He said, the Lord impressed in my heart to give him my four-wheel drive Jeep, my four-wheel Jeep, Toyota. I said, what are you waiting for? Give it to him. My friend, within 3 months, people gave him 11 cars. He began to chop life with 35 fingers.
Ah!
Borrowing the fingers of his enemies.
Ah!
And added to his hand.
Ah!
You will chop life after today. Give your neighbor high five. Say chop life.
Chop life.
With 35 fingers.
With 35
it
fingers.
Is not your fault.
It is not your fault.
It is your time.
It is your time. Power.
Take your seats. There's a serious anointing right now that is about to flow. It's a serious anointing that's about to flow. Are you ready here?
Yeah.
A man had a dream. He was working in Shell, an oil company. He had a dream. He stood in between two pits. One pit was full of gold. Another was full of excreta. From nowhere, somebody pushed him into the pit that was full of excreta. He fell into that pit in the dream. He woke up. It was 4 a.m. and he did nothing about it. By 8 o'clock, when he got to the office, he was given a sack letter. Why was he sacked? You cannot live in the pit in excreta and be working in an oil company. So that is smell. Some people's smell is so visible that now they see excreta and urine in front of their house and their shops. It's a serious manifestation. A woman, a registrar of a university, one day she heard me talk about the smell, so she came to see me. Immediately it was her turn to see me in the office. I said, yes, madam, can I help you? She stood up and came close. He said, pastor, check. Am I smelling? I said, what is it, madam? He said, am I smelling? I said, move backward. She said, please check. My husband said I am smelling. And my husband have not slept with me for 10 years. I said to her, madam, it's not an ordinary smell. It's a spiritual smell. Kneel down, let me pray for you. Immediately she knelt down. I lifted my hands to pray. The Lord opened my eyes like he opened my eyes for this young man. I saw a woman in Karo, Abuja, with wrapper on her chest, burning incense, 2 o'clock in the afternoon, with this woman's picture, sending an evil smell to that woman. And I said to her, madam, I'm seeing a vision here. Who is in Karo? I see a woman in Karo, sending evil smell on you. She said, my husband is in Karo. He's a bank manager. He has been posted to Karu for 10 years now. I said, do you know, have you been going there? He said, no, he does not allow us to come. It's only that he comes once a month, one of the weekends in a month, and visit us. I said, there is a woman in the house, and the woman is burning incense, sending you evil smell of rejection. She said, what do I do? I said, liaise with the driver of your husband and visit that house. Get to know the address. Visit the house and make sure you knock the door exactly 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And when you do that, get back to me. Let me know what has happened. She liaised with her husband's driver, gave her the address. She drove, came to that place. 2 o'clock exactly, she knocked the door. Guess what? A woman came out. We wrap her on her chest. Smoke filled the whole room. She pushed the woman and entered. Guess what she saw? Red candles and incense and her picture right there. And the woman was conjuring evil smell against her. To cut the long story short, they exchanged blows, heavy blows. So the husband came back and beat this woman. This woman I prayed for and sent her back. So I asked the woman, your husband still beat you even when you caught him with this strange woman? He said, yes. I said, I will fire him. I will sack him. I will punish him for 10 years. For tormenting you for 10 years. I, Joshua Talena, will punish him. I remove my shoe. I say, bank manager, you are fired. Fekuta ekulamanas. I command problem that you will not be able to remove your head for 10 years. And I command you, come back home. Let your wife feed you for 10 years in Jesus' name. I finished the prayer. 2 weeks after, he had problems in his bank. There were money he approved as loan in millions. And the man was at large, ran away with the money. The bank seized all his cars, seized his property. To cut the long story short, he was in jail. After 3 months, came back. He lost his job. Now sat under his wife. As I'm telling you now, today is 7 years. The man has no job. He's been begging me. I say it must reach 10 years. I, Talena, will punish you. Your wife will feed you and be sleeping with you every day. Jobless man, you will remain there. Ah! When you know who you are, nobody insults you and go free. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody.
Oh, here. Yes.
Nobody insults you and go free.
Oh, yes.
They try you, you appear in their dream and slap them properly.
Oh, yes.
Because you are connected to the heavenly supernatural source.
Amen.
Am I talking to somebody here?
Oh, yes.
How can you be a daughter in Zion? An unbeliever shook her waist and took your husband. We are. Even Sangoma worshippers, Sangoma will not allow them to take what belongs to them. How much more you who is serving the Most High God? Fine girl at 28, 30, you can't get married. Ugly ones that don't know God are getting married every Saturday. God punish the devil.
Oh, yes.
From today I declare, your marriage is released. I say it is released. I say it is released. Somebody shout fire, fire.
Fire, fire.
Pow. Take your seat. Esther chapter 2 verse 12. Esther used perfume, used anointing oil for 6 months. Verse 17, when she appeared before King Ahasuerus, she became irresistible. The Bible says she obtained favor. When you carry a good smell, you command favor. When you carry a good smell, you smell money.
Oh, yes.
When you carry a good smell, people give to you without turning back.
Oh, yes.
People can give you millions and not ask in return.
Ah.
People will cast their neck for you to climb. People will give you their back for you to climb. People will dash you this without looking.
Ah.
Somebody say, Lord, change my smell.
Change my smell.
That's all. That is all you need. Change your smell. When you carry a smell that commands respect, anywhere you enter, people turn to see who is passing. Because there is an aura. It's not physical, it's spiritual. That commands the respect of your generation. Your husband cannot ignore you anyhow. Your wife cannot ignore you anyhow. There is a presence that subdues negative powers and make them to be subjected to you because of the kind of good smell that you carry. Am I talking to somebody here?
Oh, yes.
Daniel 2:46. Daniel, the Bible said, then King Nebuchadnezzar fell down on his face and worshipped Daniel. and said, let sweet smell, sweet odors be offered to him. What it meant is Nebuchadnezzar changed the smell of Daniel. He said, you are too loaded. How can you be a gifted man and be a servant? There's no reconciliation between gift and servant. He said, no, change his smell. And when Daniel's smell was changed, in verse 46 of Daniel chapter 2, verse 48, the Bible said, then King Nebuchadnezzar made Daniel a great man. That means there is certain greatness you will never enter till you die, until your smell changes. When your smell changes, you walk less, you see more. You say, no money in this town, people are building houses. No money, people are buying cars. No money, people are opening company. Is it only you that is not seeing opportunity? Whatever cover you, I command that blanket to roast by fire. Genesis 27, the Bible said, Leah had a tender eyes, but Rachel carries the smell of favor. Leah had what? A tender eyes. But Rachel has what? The smell of favor. Tender eyes means innocent look. Your innocent look without a good smell makes you a disaster. I don't care innocent look you look. Look at me. I don't know. I don't follow men. No. I have been serving the Lord. Lord, are you still on the throne? Did you overthrow him? My friend, you need to understand that you need more than an innocent face. Leah was innocent, but the devil made sure her marriage was a waste for her. But Rachel carried the smell of favor. That is why in Genesis 27 verse 26, when Isaac wanted to bless his son, he said, come near my son and kiss me. Verse 27 of Genesis chapter 27, Isaac said to Jacob, see, the smell of my son is as the smell of the field which the Lord God has blessed. Then he went on to say, may his mother's children bow down before him. May nations submit to him. May the Lord give him the dew of heaven. May the fountains of the deep be opened. May the Lord give him the chieftains of the ancient mountains and the precious things.